Hey there, in this video, I want to talk about locked knees. Hi, welcome back. This is Owen Wei, your exercise physiologist. In some point of time, you may experience locked knees, meaning when you're trying to flex or you're trying to extend your knee, it feels like it can't allow you to do that kind of action, right? Because when you try to push a little bit more, your knee is kind of get stuck, and that's why you feel like the knee is being locked. Well, the thing about this is there's actually, well, if I were to put it broadly and general, three main reasons why you feel like your knee is being locked. So let's go down into, again, anatomy, structurally, right? This is how it looks like when your knees are put together. And it goes the same for all different joints in your body. They're usually made and created such that the joints, the one bone and the other bone, articulates very smoothly around the joint. Right, so what happens is when it's no longer smooth, you kind of get stuck. So when we talk about structure, I'm talking about bone over here, right? Because if it's mechanical, if it's a structure problem, you can get stuck by hitting something, right? So for our bone, this is the femur, which is coming from the top, and this is your tibia, which is your calf area is. And when you look at x-rays, you usually find that knees usually look like that. But there's actually like a notch that's coming out over here. So eventually your knees looks something like that, right? So there's a notch in between the tibia, right? And the femur just sits nicely over here. And when you are able to glide, right? If you're able to move properly without hitting on anything, it's supposed to glide nicely, right? Thing about this is, if it is shifted just a little bit, it can be knocking into part of the bone. And sometimes you feel like you can't push yourself so much because when it gets knocked and you try to force it through, you feel pain. And it's actually your body's way of telling you, hey, I'm knocking into the other part of the bone, please stop, you can't do this, right? And that's what you're trying to do. So from here, sometimes you feel like you need to undo the action and then try again so that when this thing is no longer stuck, it is smooth, you can continue with that again, right? So that's the structural part when the bone is being hit, or structurally it's just hitting on another surface and you feel pain, you feel like you can't carry on to go anymore, right? So the other thing about lockedness is that because of muscle imbalance, right, it can make your knee joint, because of the imbalance, right, it can shift your bone. When you're loaded and when you have the imbalance, it can make you go a little bit this way or a little bit this way. When that happens, you are going to knock onto this, or you're going to glide more onto this area or this area. You feel pain, you can't go anymore, same thing, you stop. So that's the muscle imbalance, right? The third one is what we call muscle weakness. And a lot of people also have this kind of problem because when your knee is weak, or certain muscle is weak, you feel like you can't continue to bend, right? Or continue to straighten because you don't have the strength. Right, and because you can't overcome that the force, you don't have the strength to push through, you kind of feel like it gets stuck. So for some people, they may shake a little bit, right, to make sure that they are again back into the position and they can continue to move. Or some people just can't do it, they may need some assistance, right? They may need to use their hand to try and pull or to push their knee such that they are able to pass that ankle. This has to do very much with physics. Now I'm going to use my arm over here as an example so that you can make sense of it. And a very good example over here is the bicep curl. So you think about our arm, right? Such that this is now your hamstring, right? This is your knee joint. This is your ankle. Okay? So every time when the load is the heaviest is when your hand is at 90 degrees. Okay? You can try, right? This is actually where it feels the heaviest. Once you pass this angle, it feels okay. Or it feels lighter and you can carry on. Right? So once you break that 90 degree, you're able to carry on with that movement, especially when you try to flex. Okay? So if you haven't experienced this before, you can give it a try. Right? You will feel heavier when it reaches perpendicular to where the joint is. Okay, so give it a try so you know what I meant by muscle weakness. Okay, if you don't have the strength to push through that, it will feel like you kind of get stuck as well. So, well, when you talk about locked knees, these are just how I can put it more general, more broadly, so you kind of understand how and why you can get locked knees. There can be many other reasons, unless you have a proper check, you wouldn't know. Right? And it doesn't necessarily mean that you need to go for a surgery. You just need some help. Even if you can have surgery, fixing that joint problem or that stuck feeling, right? If you don't work on the muscles, it's going to give you the same problem. Right? That can shift again. That's how it works. Right? If you have any questions, please post them at the comment section below. And if you like my video, please subscribe and please like my video. Please take care and I will see you.